First of all, I want to thank my Republican colleagues for some of the items in the resolution that we both agree on, specifically the epic restorations. But as my Democratic colleagues have said today, there are many things that we differ on. And one of the issues that I want to bring up, which is a clear difference between the Republican Majority Conference and the Democratic Conference, is the issue of hydrofracking. There are many members of the Republican majority who are great supporters of hydrofracking. Senator Livis, I can see, smiling. There are many of us on the Democratic Conference side who believe hydrofracking is the wrong way to go, including myself as the author of the bill to ban hydrofracking in New York State. But no matter which side of the aisle you're on, we need to do a health impact assessment of any health problems that may occur if New York State should go along with hydrofracking. There is a proposal, which unfortunately is not included in the Senate resolution, the Republican resolution, for a $300,000 study by one of the medical schools of SUNY to conduct a health impact assessment. I have in front of me two letters sent to the governor and Senator Skelos from over 300 doctors and medical professionals throughout the entire state, including cancer prevention organizations, basically asking for this study. And I'm just going to quote from one of the letters. More than 25% of the chemicals used in natural gas operations have been demonstrated to cause cancer or mutations. Between 2005 and 2009, according to the Committee on Energy and Commerce, hydraulic fracturing companies used 95 products containing 13 known and suspected carcinogens, all producing cancer. And in addition to, obviously, the toxic chemicals involved in the process, we also have to remember that these chemicals will be trucked throughout New York State on a daily basis. Again, reading from the same letter, natural gas drilling in New York State is predicted to increase heavy truck traffic on local roads by as much as 1.5 million more trips per year, with an average of 90 and up to 1,000 trucks per day at a single well pad. For each individual site, hundreds of tanker trucks hauling fracking fluids for injection and flowback fluids for disposal will roll through our communities and neighborhoods, and yet no one has calculated the impact on public health. I would urge the Republican majority to include $300,000 for a study on the possible health impacts. The Assembly has already included funding for such a study, and I would urge my colleagues to vote no on the resolution for that reason, as well as the other reasons my colleagues have stated. Thank you, Mr. President.